What's up, people? I am the Piper Viper, and today we're going to talk about ARK's new update, Update 248. It came out with a bunch of cool things, some optimizations, and three new dinosaurs whose names I can't even fucking pronounce, so I'm not even going to try to go there right now. But what I want to talk about today is the procedurally generated maps. Everybody keeps running around like freaking chickens when they say, what the heck is this procedurally generated map crap? And I'm here to explain it to you. Hopefully you can get it. Hopefully you can get it. So in program development, procedurally generated is in contrast to manually generated. So what we've been playing on now, the maps we've been playing on, the Scorched Earth, the Center, and the Island, are all manually generated maps. A team of developers got together and solidified the data within the map. A mountain is always here, a stream is always here, a dildo is always here, and a unicorn is always here, right? That data is compiled and saved. At that point, it's uploaded to a server, and the server uses that data so the clients can attach to it, right? It's always the same. It never changes. So procedurally generated data is different. It's not loaded or preloaded. It's not saved or transferred. What it is, it's generated on the fly. Performance of procedurally generated map is totally based on the computational power of the server. So a CPU, a GPU, and RAM, the higher amounts of that and the faster the frequency, the better improvement, rather than relying on read and write speeds of a disk where a manually saved or a manually generated map is located. So on procedurally generated, it works like this. So there'll be X coordinates and Y coordinates on the map, right? It's all blank. So the developers will say, in this section, this can happen. In this section, this can happen. Over here, this can happen. Or over everywhere, anything can happen. Them are called the variables. And an algorithm is in place by the developers to tell the computer what to generate, how to generate it. And it's all randomized. So it'll say, in this area, a chicken butt, a dildo, a unicorn, and a lesbian can spawn. I don't care what order they spawn, but these things can happen. And so it's all randomized. The computer takes that algorithm and generates it on the fly. That's quick. That's way quicker than relying on read and write speeds of a server disk. It's going to be dramatically improved. You think about games like Borderlands 2, where that's all procedurally generated and how quick it is. And No Man's Sky just came out where you can go to a whole fucking new universe without any load times. That's all procedurally generated. There's not an immense amount of data that needs to be broken down and transferred, or you don't have read and write times that you have to consistently rely on to be able to load in your maps. So that's pretty much it. As you can see in the background here, I am playing ARK. This was a procedurally generated map. As you can see on the bottom, that's what it says. And I noticed a couple things. One, it still needs some improvement. I know the developers said they're still working on it. But that being said, it is significantly less laggy, especially when you go into the biomes. Like if you're going from one biome to another, if you can remember, you get that kind of spike where the computer's like, oh my god, what the heck? And that's because the server disk is loading in that information and you have that delay time because you're relying on the read and write times of the disk. This way, it's not. You're not relying on that. You're relying on the CPU speed of the generation of that region. So it's really, really helpful and it's really beneficial. I'm anxious to see how far the devs go with this. And I think it's going to be pretty cool and it's going to be a pretty big performance improvement overall. Guys, that's all I got for today. I hope I explained it to you well. I hope it makes sense now. And if you have any more questions or concerns, just leave in the comments below. Subscribe. I love to play ARK and I love you. See you guys later. Peace.